draw one in the middle of the head, and because the head is angled, it's a little bit farther to the left. And now the eyes, which you can draw however you want, dots or whatever, and the nostrils, which should be little slits. Now we draw the belly, which is sort of like a swoop, like half a pear. And now the feet. The front one you want to have so that the sole of the foot is facing you. The other one you can draw from the side. Next, the arms, which can be varying sizes, but I like to make mine kind of big. And you can add claws at the end. And here we have the upper part of the back and then the bottom half. You can also put a wing in there. Don't forget to leave space for the wing when you're actually drawing. Right, and the tail is probably the most tricky part. You gotta draw it so it's laying on the ground in a swoop, and then back up and it's overlapping, then connect the tail to the rest of the body. Lastly, we have the spikes, which you draw along the tail, and as the tail curves around, you gotta draw the spikes in the opposite direction. We are drawing the head first, starting with the jaw nose area, then the upper head part. Not drawing it all the way, so we leave room for the spikes. Then the eyes and the nostrils.
Then the belly.
Stopping so we have room for the feet. The front one facing with the base of the foot toward you, and then the side of the foot for the other one. Then the back. And the other half of the belly, arms, with the fingers, or claws. Drawing out the tail. And the wing. And then finishing up with the spikes along the tail and back.